Appleby getting away there. He's got Martin Wood outside him. Gets the ball out to Wood. Wood's tackled on. It's on there. John Vassallo comes underneath the post for the key play. Oh, and that's good thinking by John Vassallo because he was falling all the way. But what
the defenders and offload the ball, but unable to do so. It's Moses now acting half. Joe Grimmer slips that ball to Andy Ayres. Andy Ayres is going. Appleby's going. Appleby's under the sticks. Oh, and that was a brilliant break there. A pass off the floor almost by Joe Grimmer to Andy Ayres. Andy Ayres saw Appleby on support, and the little Aussie went straight under the black dot, Darrell.
Yeah, it's a good try. That's what Keithley needed, Joe.
Joe Grimmer driving in this time. Three tackles gone as Keithley attempt to set something up once more. Appleby onto Woods. Woods gets the ball. Woods is clear. And Vassallo's in at the corner. That's a try for Keithley. That gets them to 20 points and within six, and the Lee supporters in front of us shake the fists in the air in just over this side of the field. The referee penalising Keithley there almost. As Appleby's dummy sees the gap, goes in and scores. Well, that was appalling defence.
Moses on to Appleby, Appleby to Ayres. Ayres sees the gap, goes for it, he's going on his own, he's Andy Ayres, he's outstripping the defence. Martin Woods now going in, three Whitehaven players around him, but Martin Woods sets the man over the line. Does he score? Has the referee given the try? The referee said that ball went back, and I'd also doubt that decision, but this is Keithley now in possession. Ian Gator gets the ball across, he's taken out as the ball goes, but Phil Ball it is going down the far side, on there to Andy Ayres. Andy Ayres has got support outside. Wayne Race is going for the corner, he's going under the sixes, Wayne Race, and that's a good 4 points there for Keithley, and that all came from out inside their own half. A tremendous break downfield, well finished off by Wayne Race, but one enormous break by Andy Ayres, by Phil Ball and Andy.
Of Charlie Richard Clayton, and this is Keithley out the far side. Hinchliffe gets the ball out to Vassallo. Vassallo's in
for a try there. 10 minutes on the watch as Keithley get the first try of the afternoon, Darrell.
Yes, a good try, well worked try.
Up to the top side, Joe Grimmer striding through there, almost unchallenged it would appear, in spite of having players around him. Oh, nice ball there by Paul Moses to Martin Wood. A move that must have been tried in training fields up and down the country.
Tight
midfield, Moses onto Joe Grimmer. Grimmer offloads to Gately. Gately needed to be in a running position, but he's released Appleby. Appleby's got Moses, but Appleby's leaving a lot of them. Steps inside, the fullback as though he's not there. The fullback, Richard Clayton, thumps the ground in disgust. But what a beautiful pass that was to Appleby.
And across the face of player, brings on Martin Wood again with a nice delayed pass.
Hinchliffe's going, he's got John Vassallo. John Vassallo's only got put the ball down and he scores, which he duly does in the top corner of the field. That's the third try there, and yet again, good thinking by Keithley, Darrell.
Yes, good thinking.
Martin Woods, who sweeps up, goes past the first player, goes past the second, gets the ball inside there. Andy Hinchliffe it is, who puts the ball underneath the post. Not wanting to say anything derogatory, but I wonder, I don't know, but I just wonder whether that pass to Andy was marginally forward, Darrell.
Looked it from here, John.
Joe Grimmer looking to offload. Carlton Farrell's there. Carlton Farrell's going down the bottom zone, taking the fullback on, handing the fullback off, but oh well, how well tackled there as a keeper player though, Joe Grimmer, taken out there after the ball had gone. Keithley then just through the hands of Martin Woods. Martin Woods just sees it back from Brooke Cowden. He goes under the post. Nice offload, nice run round there between Brooke Cowden and Martin Woods. Gets Keithley another 4 points and almost six.
Short at the halfway line then, Keith Dixon chips over the top, does the chasing. It's a good kick, is that?
Kicking on, it's chasing now. Is he going to regather it? Regathers perfectly, goes underneath the post. Oh, really, Darrell, that's got to be a killer for Charlie.
Yes, it really has, John. An excellent try, nice little chip over. They saw that the fullback was caught in no man's land, stuck a boot out, kicked the ball again, and the ball.
Darren Appleby then onto Martin Wood. Martin Wood misses out the player. Swift hands out to the far side there. Phil Ball it is, going down the far corner.
Going in at the far corner is Phil Ball. The referee just holds his arms out and then points to the spot. But that's another try for Keighley. 9 tries now then, they've scored. 7 of those in the second half. Andy Ayres going for the gap, he sees it, and he's under the post for the first try. 1 minute 30 seconds of the game. He's held 9 metres short. Moses, Carlton Farrell going in, and Carlton Farrell, the power and the speed of Carlton. Nonetheless, Keighley now still in the ascendancy as they look to get that point on. There's plenty of gaps to the left-hand side of the post now in the Nottingham defence. Quick hands across there, ships him in, and there's Martin Wood. And Darrell, you spotted that a fortnight ago, didn't you?
Yeah, we had him all the time with that gap, just the side of that post there. All he had to do was just get it across. Keighley had the numbers against Nottingham.
Clock, some 13 minutes of the first half remaining. Oh, and that's a suicide, and Martin Wood sniffed there, got the ball out in. Keighley unable to pick it up. He's got to move as the man, but Joe Grimmer
offers his footballing skills there, Darrell. And I don't think really Martin Wood could believe his eyes when that ball came into his hands there. On the Nottingham line, struggles to get up, he gets up, plays the ball, Paul Moses on to Appleby, Appleby to Woods, Woods out there to Keighley. Keighley feeds Mark Brooke Cowden, he's going forward, he's got players outside him, Stevenson gets the ball out, and Phil Ball gets in the corner, and that was splendid handling there from Keighley. It came from one touchline across the...
And Johnny Walker going to have to go to that touchline side, but it's not going to go in touch. He takes it, almost knocks on, but doesn't actually lose the ball. Runs strongly through the centre. Oh, Johnny Walker's going to go and score, but he's not. He's not greedy. He's given the ball to Martin Wood. Oh, really, what a brilliant run there by Johnny Walker. He could have gone down for the line himself, but he wasn't greedy. So he'd got Martin Wood in support. He gave Martin the ball, but... Hugo Park, and it looks as though it could be the start of more points for Keighley. A lovely ball there from Martin Wood out there, and it's a tremendous try there for Keighley. Only a metre to the left-hand side of the post. Mark Brooke Cowden it is, 2.5 minutes into the second. 20 metre line for Keighley. Applause from the crowd at the far side then as the ball comes out to Andy Ayres. Ayres sees the gap, goes for the gap, stretches his legs out this side to John Vazaloo. He's in at the corner for Keighley yet again. And that, well, I'm not sure, Darrell. Did John Vazaloo actually ground that ball, or did he just slide over on his winger, but deciding to take the tackle, puts the ball on the floor, plays it. Moses gets it away to Ayres. Appleby going through the centre, sees the hole. He's got a support left and right. Andy Ayres struggling to get away from the players, but Appleby's going on his own. He's got the ball out there. It's a knockback, says the referee. Andy Ayres in at the corner. Finishes off John Vazaloo, it was, who went for the ball. He couldn't get to it. Fortunately for him, it went backwards, and Andy Ayres was backing up as ever, having to do a ferreting job there. As Appleby goes through, he's going to score there, and surely that's a try. It is indeed, says the referee. The supporters behind the post there, they applaud the 10th try of Keighley this afternoon. Darren Appleby from the...
elbow down off 7.
From that Nottingham line, a bucket of water needed there to separate the players as Joe Grimmer driving in. Oh, and the ball goes to ground, but it's knocked on by Nottingham. It's Martin Wood who gets the try. The ball going up in there. I thought it was knocked up by Nottingham to play the ball. Darren Appleby there, he's got Ayres with him. He doesn't need him, does he? He'd have done better by giving him it, but he's over his own momentum, setting him in for the try. But really, Darren Appleby ought to have given that ball out to Andy Ayres, didn't he, Darrell?
Yes, he should, John. He should have watched Johnny Walker for staff. He'd have given it out then.
Yes, I'm sure he should. Came up very quickly on the play of the ball. Moses switches play, Andy Ayres gets it out to Keighley. Ian Keighley looks for the man inside, it's Andy Ayres. Nice ball there to Greg Hiley, he juggles. Paul Moses is going, Paul Moses is going, under the post, almost. And at long last, Paul Moses gets the try he's deserved this afternoon. He didn't stop, he was looking for support. I think he was wondering, Darrell, whether he got it. Halfway line, patiently waits for the Nottingham tacklers to get off him.
Ayres gets through the hole as the Nottingham man came up looking to sort him out. That's Darren Appleby. Appleby on to Moses. Oh, Moses in for another try! Paul Moses can't believe it. It must be his birthday.
But 10 metres into the half of the field of Barrow. Grimmer gets the ball into Gaffer. Gaffer does a juggling act. Turns well inside, being held by the shirt. Vazalou's coming round. Get your hand down, John, before you put the ball down. Now then, did he go over the line?
Well, the referee says it was a good try, but Darrell perhaps a loss.
But certainly a couple of very encouraging breaks already by this trialist 14, playing in the stand-off position. Ball gone back, it's wiped clean. Wayne Race going in at the corner this time for the try. And again, between the scrum half and the pack, that's twice he's taken the cheeky blindside run. And it's Martin Wood this time, onto the trialist. He steps up his right foot. Oh, and he almost got a tremendous... And that's a tremendous try there, but how close he came to getting his head taken up there by a Barrow attempted tackle of Darrell, but I don't know who this man is, but...
Barrow on this side, he's down as Gaffer busts the tackle. He's got Martin Wood outside him. That hand touched by Barrow.
He's gone there to Carlton Farrell. He attempts to get off of the tackle. Pemberton also stopped him, and Martin Wood now onto Ayres. Ayres long ball out there to Ball. Ball out to Walker. Walker does well to clutch that ball out of there. Gets it back to Ball himself. He's still looking for the line. It's Walker again. Walker's in the corner. And that's determination, is it? Yes, says the referee. He agrees. The ball going about there like it, so it was a live firework in the corner there, Cliff. Gaffer trying to duck through the tackle. Doesn't succeed though, 15 metres from the line. As Ayres now takes sway on onto Wood. Wood out to the far side, and Walker must be in. Walker's in, that's good play by Keighley. Walker scores and almost leaves the ground in the ball in the corner. But that was with the ball across field quickly, but there's nobody really there.
Thank you very much, says Keighley, and now Appleby's on his way. Appleby's going. Appleby's going to go and score. He's got the legs. He's going to score for Keighley in the corner. That's a good try for Keighley. A good interception
there. But this is Grimmer driving for the line. It's right on half-time, well, there's 2 minutes actually, and they're over.
And certainly Keighley did have something up their sleeve, because Jason Ramshaw, I believe, gone over at the side of the post there.
Back to them by Jones. Now then Ayres has got to open his legs. Appleby's still going. Gets the ball out to Martin Wood, but he's not being support. Martin Wood, he was well covered there by the defence,
but not being allowed to get up there, and the referee allowing play to go on as Grimmer gets the ball out and Keighley score. Andy Ayres, we believe, it certainly is, he pushes the air. Andy Ayres scores for Keighley, 8 minutes of the second half gone, and that was opportunism again, Darrell, that Keighley kept that...
We're underway again then. That winger John Morgan there coming in, taking the first drive. And that's the hook of Penman once more. 10 metres from the Keighley 20 metre line. Gally Schubert. He's held. Gets up though, plays the ball. Kitchen, the man with the ball at the moment, ducking underneath the initial tackle by Martin Wood, but hangs on tightly to him. Steve Hall does the sweeping, the cleaning up rather. That was a very poor pass by Dean Marwood back, but they do well to regather. And it's Brad Heppey. And there's a penalty there given against Keith for a punch in the tackle. 10 metres, and the captain there, Colin Armstrong, telling the referee that Wayne Kitchen's going to have a go for goal. Certainly will be a good kick if he kicks it. It's something like, well, it's almost 30 metres from the try line in a straight line, so with the angle it'll be pushing 35 metres to those posts, and it's straight into the teeth of a wind which is peaking at times almost at gale force.
Yeah. foot to the far side. It's going to go dead though. Certainly got the distance and the wind didn't seem to take too much effect, but nonetheless it's a dropout. 15 minutes of the first half gone then. Dropout, Keith Dixon it will be, to put this ball deep, deep downfield. Fullback David Loudon, met there by Jason Ramshaw, but releases the ball in the tackle, and that's going to be a scrum down. Certainly good pushing in after the tackle was made. Jason Ramshaw initially made the tackle. In and out then to Keighley as Keith Dixon gets on to Andy Inchliffe. Inchliffe plays the ball, it's Dixon on to Steve Hall. Steve Hall displaced in the front row, of course, with the arrival of Ian Gately and Joe Grimmer, but should get the opportunity to run, and that's another high tackle. Again, like the first high tackle, certainly not vicious. It was one of those things that the arm was up high on the body, the player was sliding down as the tackle was made, and the head appeared to be attacked. Certainly quite innocent as far as injury is concerned, or potential injury, like the first one, but not at all like the second or the third penalty given for a similar offence. John Vazalow then, been told by Joe Grimmer to have a pot at goal. He's already been successful with one from this side of the field. Left-footed though, and the wind coming back in its original position of diagonally across the field won't really help the left-footed player. A left-footed kick. Ball there just falling over. It's high. And the crowd are saying it's good, and so the touch judges. Well, well. John certainly seems to have his kicking boots on. Keighley there, 19 minutes into this first half, and the score 4-0 in the Cougars' favour. Hanging kick there, who's going to take it? Inchliffe it is, who does take it. He's tackled there by the Workington captain, the ball hooked back. Certainly the Keighley coaching team will not be happy that a player the ball is so slack, particularly inside their own half, allowing the opposition the ball, and on the first tackle at that. Ball moving across there, loose forward. Oglenby taking the ball in onto the 20-metre line. Tackled and dumped by Steve Hall. Ball moving across the park. Kitchen pulls that ball out wide. Ball goes back though. The player needed hitting hard there. Ian Gately it was who was left to do it after Jason Ramshaw slowed him down. Armstrong, last tackle indicated by Mr. Crashley. Ball high in the air. That's gone directly into touch. So we'll have a handover. 25 metres from the Cougar line. Gately it is to play the ball. Steve Hall taking that first drive in. Gaining 5 or 6 metres, and the extra one on his knees there. Ramshaw out to Grimmer. Grimmer met again by a fair old posse of players. And the referee penalised Joe Grimmer there for not playing the ball correctly. Well, well, how many times when watching television do you see that happen? The referee takes no notice of it. The other Churian Whites over the other side of the Pennines, pretty clever at doing that, rolling the ball between the legs and get away with it 9 times out of 10. Mr. Crashley there must have been 7 or 8 metres from the man doing it, and yet saw that he didn't put the ball to foot. So then it's Heppy gets the play underway. Kitchen into second row. McGuirk. Hooker Penman onto Kitchen, spots the gap in the middle, but the gap closes as quickly as it had opened. Driving back down the centre is Armstrong, offloads him. What again, looked a bit forward, but the referee on the spot says no, and Keithley driving the man. Are they going to take him to the halfway line? They certainly took him 15 metres from the line there, the second row, number 12, Barry Burglas. Oglenby driving into, back into that Keithley 20-metre territory. Penman onto Kitchen, Kitchen out to the scrum half. A long pass out there to Loudon, who's chasing a kick forward. Oh, and the ball knocked forward, and it's in touch though. Interesting to see, I didn't see who did it, but now Mr. Crashley indicated that it's a Workington Town put-in. Workington put-in, I beg your pardon. In and held in the scrum. Dipping in the back there to get it out as a scrum half. Oh, and that's a bad miss there by Andy Inslick, but that's a well picked up there. Oh, and there's another fist going in way behind Mr. Crashley, not seeing it. In at the head. Andy Ayres. Well, the referee's penalised Workington on 4 occasions for high tackles, and he's let a couple go there, which I have to say, in all honesty, somewhere in front of the touch judge. And that's twice that touch judge, Mr. Jackson, on that far side of the field, has not really given the players any protection or offered the referee any assistance. Referee now making sure the scrum does form 10 metres in. That ball looked to come out the same way, but Kitchen jinking his way through. 10 metres inside the Cougars' half before being tackled. Schubert and Jorgen are penalised there for the punch in the tackle. Well, now then, did he say it was a punch, or did he say hit him round the head? It certainly was a swinging arm, but the referee indicated that it was in the top half of the body, presumably near the head. So then, 20 metres from the Cougars' line as Heppy plays the ball onto the scrum half, onto standoff, and it's Schubert, the second row there. Penman. Onto Armstrong. Armstrong gets that ball away. It's Burglas there, standing up, looking to be hit down, and Keithley players just standing there looking at him. Eventually they do put him down to ground, and that player certainly didn't play the ball from the correct spot. Gately being put in a position out of position. That's Brad Heppy, tackled on the far touchline side by Ian Gately. Stevie Hall just in there as well, 10 metres though from the Cougars' line. 25 minutes of the first half gone then, wing, Kitchen. And that's a bad mistake by Workington, very lucky to get that ball back. It's the last tackle now. That ball's looked to be going into touch, but it's not Phil Ball, it was Technic. Referee obviously satisfied there that the two players tackling were behind the man who kicked the ball. stung down injured there, but he's getting up. Keighley gets driven back towards that try line. Gaither driving the ball out. Needs a ball downfield from the kicker as Andy Ayres now looks for the gap. Almost gets away, brings the crowd to the feet in the stand at the far side. Always an exciting player, Andy Ayres, when he's running. Ball thrown away, it's the last tackle as Martin Wood, at long last, is aware of it, drives the ball deep downfield. And so that's a tap restart on the 20-metre line. But little lacks of concentration there in defence by Keighley, just concerned about getting the ball away. Ought to be aware of the fact that they've got this very strong wind behind them, and that ball ought to be going downtown, taking advantage of the wind and the slope. They've got 40 minutes to play against that in the second half. Referee getting in the way there, but it's Schubert, offloads. The ball not being taken when the tackle's been made. Martin Wood, though, there, taking advantage of Workington running round in circles. Pullback Loudon it was. Ball out, missed. I feel that should have gone to the centre, number three, Heppy, but Rooney was the man who received it. Kitchen 10 metres from the halfway line. Keighley coming forward. That's a knock-on, but it's picked up by Martin Wood. Suspect a knock-on both ways. Indeed, indicated by Mr. Crashley. Knock-on both ways. Martin Wood just not able to pick it up cleanly at the first attempt. But my words, had he been able to, he'd an almost clear run to that Workington line. Ayres, that ball didn't really go in. And the Dean Marwood, the Workington scrum half, deemed to have been offside, not retiring behind the scrum. But certainly I didn't think the ball had gone in. Almost 30 minutes gone now of the first half. Keighley 20 metres from the line. Johnny Walker getting almost his first touch of the ball this game. Takes the first drive in, Stevie Hall driving in towards those posts. And there's a Workington Town player there underneath that lot who should have been awarded a RADA award there for acting as Joe Grimmer came through. He went splat out, laid down like a cross on the floor. Mr. Cashley taking no notice of it, and for his troubles, he got the full weight of a couple of players on top of him when the tackle was made. But, scrum collapsing there. Edinburgh still to Workington, 10 metres from their line. Ball gone in, Keighley giving a big push here, but the ball coming out eventually. Marwood being wrapped up in front of his own post by Martin Wood. Good clearing run of 10 metres there by the fullback. It's a good amount of ground made there by Paul Burns, but it was across the field rather than up the field. Still inside his own 20-metre area. Big shoulder charge tackle there on Schubert, McQuirk. And Keighley regathered the ball. McQuirk Schubert, as Gately now comes forward. Offloads there. Keith Dixon on hand to pick up as Ken Kerr, the new Australian signing, gets them all. Not really had much opportunity as Keith Dixon now goes in, looking for that gap. Kerr acting halfback. Plays the ball onto Andy Ayres. Andy Ayres goes for the gap in the centre, looks for the man running, but there's nobody running. He was working his way towards Martin Wood over there, but was tackled 8 or 9 metres from that Workington line. Grimmer gets the ball out, looks for the gap, looks for the man. Out to the wing, is it forward? And the touch judges on the far side after a Keighley player is Ian Gately, still on his knees there. came on and said, I believe he's telling the referee that a Workington player interfered. But we shall see in a moment. He's obviously going to say something. He's telling the Keighley players just to move away. Gately's looking a little bit starry-eyed at the moment. He's told the physio he's OK, hands on the back of his head. Referee still in deep consultation with the touch judge on that far side. And it's a Workington man, he's pulling out. And the crowd agree, it's the right man. In fact, he's called the captain across, I beg your pardon. It's not the captain he's talking to, he's just told the captain that maybe next time that man will be sitting in the dressing room. So John Vassilou going to try that trusted left boot again to convert the indiscretion there into points. 32 minutes or thereabouts. Vassilou then attempting to convert his third penalty of the afternoon. The crowd are saying it's good, and again the touch judges agree. 33 minutes, I make it on the clock. Still the score then, points all to John Vassilou. All for penalties, and all three penalties for foul play. Again, that same deep kick, well fielded there by Keith Dixon, looks where the players are, sees that they're well off, and that ball is going to go dead, and so Workington are going to have to go back to their own 20-metre line to restart. It's hard work running up that hill, only to have to walk all the way back down again for those forwards. And certainly Workington will be taking great note of that slope and that wind. And I feel we'll be doing exactly the same in the second half to Keighley, given the opportunity. Ian Gately driving that man back, McGuirk. And that's Burgless. Look to put that ball down, and good spotting there by Jason Ramshaw. Saw that the opportunity was coming, and that's another bad mistake by Oglenby this time for Workington. That's bad discipline, nothing less. Not allowing Ramshaw to get up and play that ball. In fact, he was standing up, but he wouldn't allow him to play, holding the arms. Ramshaw struggled, and the referee rewarded him with the penalty. Just a little bit disappointed that we haven't seen too much handling by Keighley this afternoon so far. But I think when you go down to pitch level, I think we'll find that those conditions down there are not exactly what are conducive to good handling. And certainly it's a game of percentages, I think, with the wind as strong as it is. The rain is in the wind as well. It's starting to rain reasonably heavily now, but it's been drizzling all the game. The ball's quite greasy, it's very slippery underfoot, so not really the best of conditions to produce good handling rugby. Nonetheless, it's at the moment 6-0 to Keighley, and that's 8-0. That's through the middle. John Vassilou. Thirty-seven minutes then, I reckon, that goal was scored on. three left, just being one or two short hold-ups for attention to players and where the clock's being stopped as Kitchen gets the ball down. And again, same tactics again. Is the fullback aware of it? And yes, he was that little bit further downfield that time. Oh, and he loses the ball. But the referee is not going to allow play to continue. He's penalised Keighley for not giving the man the necessary yardage. And I think I have to agree with Mr. Crashley on that instance. Martin Wood, I think it was, who was the man who was up. And of course, Jason Ramshaw, the two players there who were up and harassed him. He'd taken the ball cleanly, he's looking to make yardage, but they didn't give him the necessary 10. But interesting to see that that fullback is suspect under pressure. They hit him hard and the ball spilled out. And Martin Wood was there to pick up and on his way to the line. If only Mr. Crashley hadn't have blown his whistle. As it is, play is now 20 metres from the, 10 metres inside the Keighley half of the field. Joe Grimmer tackling the winger, John Morgan. I beg your pardon, yes, John Morgan it was. Steve Hall there also doing a big hit. Kitchen spotting that gap, gets through it, he's got support left and right. Dixon's with him, and in fact, Kitchen took the wrong option there. He'd got four players in support outside, and he ran away from them all the time. But this is Armstrong, offloads there to the standoff, Oglenby. Beg your pardon, to loose forward, Oglenby. Marwood gets that ball away there to McGurk. But he's tackled 10 metres short of the keeper line. Need to keep Workington out to Keighley, and that's a good ball out there, I believe, to number 5, Paul Burns, who's wandered across. It was the last tackle. The handover, Ian Gately plays that ball. I believe Martin Brooke Cowden there. Gately again, dropping the shoulder there to meet the would-be tackler. Ramshaw again, that ball hooked back. But it's back to one. Oh, Andy Ayres checking up and up top end. Oglenby certainly likes the tackle top end. I'm not saying it's unfairly, but it's certainly top body area. Steve Hall hurled to the ground there. Ramshaw looking to go on his own. And it's Hall this time going on his own. That's two or else three of those, this sequence of tackles where they've gone up Keighley, have gone on their own from acting half-back. Steve Hall struggling to get up there, Schubert lying in the ways. Dixon boots that ball down, failed, and finds the David Loudham, almost a hole-in-one there. But Martin Wood, interestingly enough, on hand, not to allow Loudham to go any further forward. And it's the winger there, Paul Burns this time, 10 metres from the halfway line. I make time almost to be up in this half then. Keighley currently leading 8-0, those four penalties by John Vassalou. Armstrong, the captain, mounted there by Jason Ramshaw, the extra weight to bring him down. Oh, and that looked forward, but the man spilled the ball. But it certainly looked forward. The referee giving the knock on. The referee, in fact, quite a long way from the action there. But of course, he does have the assistance of a touch judge who can indicate the forward pass if he so wishes. Just inside the Keighley half of the field then. Andy Ayres puts the ball in, comes out to them, but Dixon there misses it. Ian Gately and in fact, Dixon unable to recover the ball. I beg your pardon, it wasn't Ian Gerton, it was Ken Kerr. Referee just stops the clock. It's almost half time. In fact, I suspect now the 40 minutes are up. Might be certainly on my watch. And I feel sure that he'll be opting for a penalty attempt. Indeed, he is. It's almost in front of the post. It's some 35 metres from the post. And would you believe it, the wind has slackened off considerably. The flags not exactly hanging limp, but certainly not going out straight as ramrods as they were earlier. Dean Marwood then attempts to put Workington on the score sheet. Well, it's certainly got the distance and it's got the direction. So that's 8-2 to Workington, two Keighley then. Certainly a very vociferous Workington supporting group underneath us here, letting them know the players that they're there. And that's a deep kick to Armstrong, and Paul Byrne running across field looking to get to that 20 metre line, which he does before being brought down by Gately and Mark Brooke-Cowden. That's Burgless tackle. Referee just going to get his socks in view there to those players, let them know he's about. Oh, that's a nice ball out to this side, and an equally good one inside, but what a good tackle there by Phil Ball, and the ball knocked on both ways, and that's the half-time whistle, but that ball knocked on both ways. Phil Ball not able to hang on to it, but Workington had knocked on before, but both sides save further efforts this half. As we reach the end of the first 40-minute period with a scoreline of Keighley 8, Workington 2, and all the points coming from penalty goals. Just having a look around the Workington side, already retake the field. You don't see any changes there though. And as the Keighley side also retake the field, we'll keep a look out there for a clean shirt. Doesn't look to be one indeed. The substitutes still the same. Paul Moses making his way back to the bench, as is Carlton Farrell. Just a little bit of spontaneous entertainment from some of the juniors during the half-time break, keeping the crowd well attuned and entertained during that 10-minute break. And certainly some of those young kids wearing the Keighley supporters shirts are anything to go by on the future of Keighley Rugby League, then there's a great prospect in future. So we get restarted then. Keith Dixon does the honours, regathered inside the try area by wingman John Morgan. Ball driving back downfield. 20 metres then, nobody there marking him as the two players doing the tackle roll off in the wrong direction. Jason Ramshaw then does that tackling 10 metres inside the Workington half. That's Gary Schubert. And Steve Hall penalised there for not allowing the player to get up. Now Wayne Kitchen preferring not to kick out of his hands, but puts that ball on the ground and kicks it firmly into touch. 10 metres, or 30 metres, we're going to have to get used to these new yards with yard markings. 30 metres from the keeper line. That's Kitchen looking to jink there between Mark Brooke-Cowden and Jason Ramshaw, but not able to. Hooker meets hooker there. It's Mark Schubert, 20 metres from the keeper line. Four tackles gone eye making as Armstrong leads the charge towards the keeper line for Workington. That's not four, that's must be four then. Only a nice ball out there to the hooker from loose forward Oglenby. But a knock on, and a knock on both ways, so it'll be scrum down. Eight or 9 metres from the Keighley line, Andy Ayres to put this ball in then for Keighley, in it goes. And that scrum broke up in most unusual fashion as the Keighley pack going one way and the Workington front row coming the other way. Phil Ball looking to get away there from the attentions of the Workington forwards, not able to do so. That's Ian Gately, gets 20 metres out before being brought down. Matt Brooke Cowden, a further 10 metres. Valuable yards away from his own line there. And Jason Ramshaw gets a nice ball out there to John Walker, carrying that ball low, but running back to the ruck of players. 10 metres inside his own half. The referee has his hand in the air. Vazalou punts that ball low down, into touch. Just over 10 or 11 metres inside the Workington half of the field. Wind once more picking up, bringing with it the rain. And Keighley, of course, playing straight into the face of it this half. Got a very difficult task and only a cushion of 6 points. Nice break there down the centre of the field by Byrne. 8 or 9 yards inside his own half. Workington covered across, and there's a bit shorter numbers at this side. Phil Ball held back there. He did knock the ball on, but he was held back in trying to recover it and give the scrum, and that's another drop ball, and another drop ball. And certainly the first drop ball went back, but the second ball didn't, and the referee missed it. He couldn't have seen it, but again, as I said so often in this game, he does have touch judges, and he either's not using them, or they're not helping him. But certainly scrum half, Dean Marwood did drop that ball a second time, and it should have been a scrum down. But still, it's 10 yards inside the keeper half of the field. Kitchen gets that ball inside, and that's to Schubert. Schubert offloads to Marwood. Tackled as he got the ball there. And Keighley caught offside over this side of the field. In fact, it's Ian Gately who's been given offside. He was running across to cover the gaps. Centre Heppy there, getting almost to the keeper line before being brought down. Good charge there by McKirk. Kitchen acting half back, brings in his captain and front forward, Colin Armstrong, but he's well met by the keeper defence there. Ball out to this side, it's opposite centre, Neil Rooney. Rooney and Heppy operating very much very closely together. And that's Schubert taking the ball and gets it out to Kitchen, but he's again met by that tackling machine of the Keighley pack. The referee got his hand in the air, it's the last tackle. And what are they going to do? It's a kick forward for the far side. Well dropped on by John Walker, but the ball shot away from him underneath. And as the referee has said, no try, the man's on his back. And the loose forward looks at the touch judge and appeals to him. Certainly it looked to me as though one of the Workington players was celebrating, but the referee said no. The player was held on his back, difficult to see who it was. So it's a 10-yard scrum then, 10-metre scrum, beg your pardon. Ball in, it's not out though, and it's a penalty in fact to... penalty there, and the two front rows having a little bit of a tuna throw, but is he going to say what it's for? I don't know. Certainly no indication by the referee other than the differential penalty. So it's Penman then to take this tap, having put the ball back in touch. Byrne driving in towards the post. Let's go! He's doing a little tap dance with his boot toes there, trying to milk a penalty. The referee having none of it as Kitchen gets the ball to Oglenby, almost losing the ball in the tackle, Oglenby, but gets it out. This time that's Schubert, he does lose the ball. And how many more times they're going to try and score the there, but certainly Penman thought he was going to get away with that, but the referee had different ideas. Every single one of the Workington players inside the cleek in a 20 metre area as this scrum goes down 10 metres from the keeper line. That ball certainly didn't go in the scrum. Ball out, loose forward, breaking very quickly from the base and from the back of the scrum there. As Ayres plays the ball to Dixon, Dixon onto Wood. Wood looks for a way through, spins it away from the first tackler, but he's brought down 20 metres from his own line. Ramshaw looks, gets the ball out there. It's Andy Ayres looking to come left, deciding to come straight forward though. Ramshaw onto Grimmer, Joe Grimmer coming up this hill. And every time he's had that ball in anything, oh, and there went a fist, and right in the face, number 11, Gary McCourt, threw an almighty punch there at Joe Grimmer in front of Mr. Crashley's eyes, and he chose not to do anything about it. But the ball's gone the far side of the field there. John Walker not taking the men on as perhaps he ought to have been doing. It was the last tackle. It's Keith Dixon there, pushes the ball downfield. Loudham coming down, and the referee's going to penalise Steve Hall this time for dropping with the elbow, I think. Well, no, he certainly didn't let him get up. I mean, he was tackling him and he was hauled away. As the rain comes down heavily now here. Fortunately, we do have a roof on the top of us. No front sides or backs, but we've got a roof. Ooh, a bit of a swinger there from Ian Gately, referee allowing it to go. Armstrong running in, leading with his hand as Steve Hall it was in the way of any further progress. Kitchen out again to Oglenby. Oglenby gets the ball out to this wing there, John Morgan. John Morgan looking for a way through, but no way through for him as Andy Ayres and Ken Curtis do the tackling. Gary Schubert certainly not displayed the best of pair of hands this afternoon. And the referee penalising Workington this time for, it looks like, not playing the ball correctly. Indeed. So that's 1-1 on that score then. Penalties, not incorrectly playing the ball. Keith Dixon then just waits for Martin Wood to come back into an onside position before putting the ball safely into touch. Ramshaw, Gately running hard again and certainly receiving the three-man treatment and the respect of this working side. Oh, that's a nice break there by Stevie Hall. Tackle about the head again. And I don't really know, it was tackle about the head. It was number 10 initially who tackled him, but he was caught a second time in the eyes, I suspect, gouging there. But that wasn't the tackle that I saw. The one I saw was number 10, Gary Schubert. Gary Schubert who did it. I don't know who did the eye job. But the referee is going to have to do something about this. The first half started in this vein. With Workington going up top all the time. And you don't see a big fella like Steve Hall down on the floor unless he's hurt. Trying to make a mental note as to whether how many eyeballs he's got in his head. He knows he should have to. And the referee has given a head-high tackle. Dixon then puts that ball into touch, 20 metres from the Workington line. Jason Ramshaw restarts out to Ayres. Joe Grimmer coming in, driving that ball into the 20-metre territory. Ramshaw once more operating the acting half-back. Gately running straight there from that pass from Andy Ayres. Driving in towards these Workington posts. Keithley coming forward still. Ayres out there to Mark Brooke-Cowden. Swipes off the first tackler of the scrum half, Marwood. Keithley have got the numbers if they play the game right. Oh, and they've taken the wrong option there. But the elbow, the touch judge never saw the elbow on Steve Hall yet again. No, it's not Steve Hall. It's Martin Wood. Ken Kerr looking for that line this time, then 4 or 5 metres short. Martin Wood back in the line as the ball's chipped over. Oh, and Andy Inchcliffe! Andy Inchcliffe it is, who goes through. It looked to me it was Keith Dixon, I believe, who popped the ball up. I believe it was Keith Dixon who popped that ball up, and Andy Inchcliffe latched onto it like a... latched onto that ball like a man possessed and banged it down in that try area. 10 minutes then of the second half gone. Andy Inchcliffe bringing that Keithley score into double figures. John Vazalil then with possibly the hardest kick of the four that he's had so far. This is the fifth, of course. Possibly the hardest of all. The wind straight into the teeth of the wind. And we saw what happened when, I believe it was Kitchen, had a penalty attempt from a very similar position in the first half. Certainly got the distance, but the wind pushed the ball to the far side of the right-hand upright. Taking a great deal of care as he lines it up. It's up and it's high, but well, the wind didn't do its job and pull it round. Certainly the wind creating all types of havoc up here with our notes, etc. But we've gathered them all together now then as Kitchen restarts following that magnificent Andy Inchcliffe try. After a try like that and then a handling of a... So then it's a scrum down 20 metres then from the Keithley line. Workington get the ball in and out, Kitchen onto the centre. Heppy into the Keithley 20-yard area. That's McGurk. 10 metres now from the Keithley line. Short at the far side on numbers. Workington certainly got the numbers there. Heppy it is going in. Heppy's going to reply, is he? No, he's held short. In fact, he's held on his back again. That's twice Workington has crossed the line. And how on earth Keithley managed to get under that player's, underneath that player and hold him on his back, I don't know. But do it they did and save themselves 4 points. But they were very short on numbers over there with Keithley. And Heppy certainly saw the gap that came from that shortage. Oh, and that's one against the head there. Beg your pardon, yes, in fact, it's the new rule coming into play there. It's the attacking side head and ball. And the ball being lost there by Oglumby and regathered by Keithley. 12 points to 2, the scoreline reads. Keithley encamped in their own 20-metre area at the moment as Steve Hall comes forwards, looks to get outside that area. He's certainly been held very tightly there by Colin Armstrong, not giving an inch either way. Andy Ayres looks for the gap, saw it was there, but certainly it closed down almost as quick as it opened. Mark Brooke Cowden breaking out of the 20 area. Ball back to Keith Dixon. This will be a very interesting kick because that wind's hard. Referee waves play on. Ken Kerr there does that tackling with Ian Gairfley. McGurk refusing to go down, but he falls to the additional weight there, put in by Gairfley. An almost voluntary tackle there by Schubert as he slips on the wet grass. Kitchen going for a gap and open there, he saw it. And Steve Hall intercepted. Good interception there by Steve Hall from that pass from Kitchen as he strode through a gap that opened up in front of him. Oh, and there's all hell on there now. They've certainly picked out Steve Hall, and that's number 11. Number 11, Gary McGurk, who has been incidentally one or two of these incidents. He came in and he laid an almighty pounding into the head of Steve Hall as he laid on the floor there. Referee holding up play, is pulling in a touch judge. The referee, quite frankly, was unsighted. And Colin Armstrong there is trying to tell the referee who he should be pulling out on the Keighley side. He's either doing that or marking the man for later. Difficult to see what the referee is going to do here because there's a Workington player down on the floor still. Who we believe is the man who was incidental in the play of the ball incident where the referee wiped it back and there was the boot kicked through where he attempted to kick the ball and got the man. And he's sending two to the sin bin. He's sending Steve Hall to the sin bin. I'm not sure who else. He's certainly sent one, certainly sent a Workington player to the sin bin, but I haven't seen who it is yet. Well, certainly the referee sent two to the sin bin, one on each side, but Workington Town has still got 13 players on the field. In fact, the fullback Loudham is off the field now, but I'm not sure. I believe he's been substituted as John Walker goes down. And there's the man who should be off the field, in my opinion. He's just dumping Walker on the floor, he's number 11. We're just doing the number counting up here. We believe there's still 13 players on the field as Gaither takes one high there. 10 metres inside the Workington half of the field, and Martin Woods just has a quick word with Heppe. Ball knocked out, gone backwards, says the referee. Martin Woods picks it up. He's going to have to make his mind up what he's doing. John Walker takes the ball, but it goes into touch. Not a difficult, not an easy ball to take. There are only 12 Workington players on the field. We've just had a head count now. The fullback is in on the bench. Whether he's the one that went to the bin or not, I don't know. But Byrne then plays the ball for Workington. Player getting underway, settling down once more. Wind picking up again. Something like halfway through this second half. A ball spill there by Rooney. Walker needs to go at that touchline side, take them on, gets the ball inside, and the edge is going! And the edge, arm in the air! He takes a dive into the mud behind the post at Lockholm Lane, end of the ground, punches the air, and that was a good try there by Keith Lee. Johnny Walker making the break up the touchline side, decided the ball was the place to put the ball was inside, in it went to Andy Ayres and he went like a rabbit for the line. 10 metres to the right-hand side of the post, 21 minutes in the second half then, as Keighley increased that lead to 16 points to 12 thanks to that and the Ayres try. I beg your pardon, 16 points to 2. Down now as John Vassalou takes great care lining this conversion attempt up. Ball falls over, referee just holds the clock. But certainly how the crowd came to their feet in the stand there and all around the ground as the blistering pace of Andy Ayres finished off that break by John Walker. And John Vassalou puts the extras on. ...18-2 the score then. John Vassalou, fifth goal of the afternoon. But certainly saying in the first half that we hadn't seen too much handling by Keighley and that the conditions were not that for good handling. But my words, that was certainly handling as it's... Oh, really, really, there's a touch judge there. And Mr. Heppy almost took the throat off Ken Gear, his old teammate, up at Workington. And Gear... Ken Kerr just looked and smiled at him and said, you're going to have to do a little bit better than that. On the 20 metre line then, Keighley, Jason Ramshaw out to Dixon. Keith Dixon appealing that ball, that tackle was head high, and as Colin Armstrong came up, his arm was still round. Oh, dearie me! Well, well, well. It is never head high. The man's having to be pulled into the recovery position. If that was head high, well, quite frankly, I don't know what this touch judge on this side is saying. He's saying absolutely nothing. Ken Kerr is sparker on the floor. And all the referee has given is a forward pass. My words, that's rather a disgrace, I'm afraid. It's an indictment on the referee. And is it a wonder that referees gain the wrath of the crowd when they're allowed that sort of thing to go? It's absolutely appalling. Absolutely appalling. And there's a bit of crossing there. It's certainly using the man. Oglumby take that pass there from Marwood as Schubert tackled as he's trying to get 20 metres to the 20 metre line. Doesn't get there. Keighley, in fact, have a substitute on. Byrne looking to get that ball away, looking for his support. He had it left and right, but didn't get the ball out. Armstrong switching that ball. But it's McGurk tackled. Last tackle as Armstrong puts the ball high in the field, and I think that's going to go out of the ground. Very well judged. Certainly didn't take into account the strength of the wind as he put that ball high in the air. Ian Gately looks as though he may be coming off. The number 8 board in the hands over there and Paul Moses coming on. Interesting to see now where Paul goes to play. Of course, two hookers on the field. Oh, a nice ball out there. Carlton Faddle well met though. by Paul Byrne. Carlton Farrell on the field for Andy Hinchcliffe. Oh, and that's a good follow there by Keith Dixon. Pins his opposite number down there. Epi. Schubert. Throwing a punch there as Joe Grimmer. Ball lost in the tackle, in fact. Joe Grimmer penalised there for... Well, the referee says the knee, but I think he was just having a little bit of a niggle round the with the boot, was Joe Grimmer there. And it's Workington now making a substitution. It's number 10, Gary Schubert, they're taking off. Ian Scott coming on with the 15 shirt on. Ball just falling over there. Rain absolutely lashes down here now. Certainly a good deep kick there by Kitchen. 15 metres from the Keith line as Marwood gets the ball out there to Penman. Penham. Kitchen works at acting half back. Pushing the keeper player off his feet as Armstrong comes through now then. Armstrong dropping on with the knee on Ramshaw, and it's Marwood looking to work their way through the keeper defence, but there's no way through. Penman acting half back onto Kitchen. Well tackled there by Martin Wood and Paul Moses. Penman going on his own, loose ball, dived on there, and that's never a knock-on. The ball going back as Steve Hall dropped on it. Paul Moses knocked the ball back. But it must have been the first knock-on, in fact, it was the first knock-on that the referee has given Workington already having knocked on. Carlton Farrell then from acting half, bounces off the first would-be tackler, tries to come to this side but unable to get round, struggling, trying to milk a penalty there as Steve Hall now coming forward. Certainly Steve Hall will know he's been in the game this afternoon, because every time he's been tackled there's been at least three Workington players around him, and there's been plenty of weight going in him as well. Rain lashing down into the Keighley faces now. Martin Wood jiggles one way and then the other. Ball's lost though, but does well to regather it. Prevents Workington getting that ball on the first from the drop, and gives Keighley the opportunity of. Interest there. Paul Moses gone at hooker. Jason Ramshaw in the second row, and Steve Hall in the prop position, of course, as you'd expect him with Ian Gately off the field. McQuirk bounces away from that tackle. Oh, and almost an interception there by Brooke Cowden. Nearly got it. The unfortunate thing, when you go for interception, there's a nick. I think the referee is a little bit harsh there, saying that was holding down. More a hand on the shirt than a holding down, but he's the man with the whistle, he's the man that makes the decisions, and we have to grin and bear them whether we like it or not. Scott then, the substitute for Workington, driving in 10 metres from the keeper line. Half an hour of this second half gone, 10 minutes remaining. As the ball released there in the tackle by Oglenby to Burglas. And we're 5 metres from the Keighley line then. Defence holding firm so far this afternoon. Kitchen looked to switch the ball but dropped it. It's a knock on both ways. The type of thing we expect in these conditions. Knock on both ways. Paul Moses unable to hang on to it, but it should be a Keighley ball. And in fact, the heading ball is being given to Workington. Now, then that to me is strange. Knock on both ways means Workington, who are attacking, must have knocked on first. But not according to Mr. Crashley. In fact, he's not allowing that. And in fact, he's walking well in field. A penalty for not packing correctly. And that's a forward pass. Oh, dearie me. Well, there was a forward pass there. Mr. Crashley ignored it. But Workington couldn't hang on to the ball, so it's a tap 25 and Keith, they breathe again. Oh, and that was a silly, silly pass. A silly, silly pass to give there. The conditions are so bad. The ball will be like a lump of soap, and Keith Dixon tried to get that ball out. And certainly not the best of ideas. Ball switched to the blind side. Epi gives it out to Morgan. Morgan tackled though. 10 metres from the keeper line as the white lines fade in the rain. Armstrong driving the ball in for Workington. Plays the ball, Penman onto Marwood. Marwood to Kitchen. Kitchen looking for somewhere to go. There's nowhere for him to go there though. As he's picked up and dropped. Penman goes from acting half-back on his own, but there's nowhere for him. Joe Grimmer spotting the fact that he was going that way. Shut it down as Jason Ramshaw did the tackling. Armstrong allowed to get that ball out, this time to Oglenby, and they've certainly got the numbers here, but that ball's too strong. Far too strong a kick there from, I believe, Oglenby for the winger to chase. Ball going into touch, so yet another 20 metre tap for Keighley, and need to hold on to this ball, certainly for the set of six if possible. On my watch, around about 7 or 8 minutes left yet. Ball lost there in the tackle. Oglenby this time gets the ball out to Heppy. Heppy tackled, half tackled there by Kerr, but gets the ball away. And Marwood off to Scott. Scott to Kitchen. Kitchen out to Walker. Walker says thank you. Runs straight into a Workington player. Scott charging in there as the fourth man in the tackle. Uses a shoulder to put the men down. Ball hitting Carlton Farrell's boot there, fortunately, not his hand. Keighley needs to realise that back to one. The ball, the slate wiped clean, and here we go, they're squaring up again. The ginger hair of Schubert there, temper fiery. Squaring up an offering, and it looks like there was a bit of offering there whilst everything was going on. And in fact, the man who's been in the sin bin, the fullback Loudham, is in fact the man who was in the middle of that again. Going away, wagging fingers and pointing. But really, if he's going to do any pointing, he wants to look at the scoreboard, because that's what matters. And the score on there is 18-2 in favour of Keighley. And there's no real reason why the tempers should be flaring by Workington at the moment, because they're the ones who have been doing all the aggro, certainly with the high tackles. Steve Hall holds tightly on. And just has a quick look up to see McGurk. He knows McGurk as the man who threw the punch there. Second man in the tackle did Stevie Hall. He saw who did it. We've seen him doing it all the time. Martin Wood could have been accused of crossing there. That's back to one. Steve Hall hangs tight on. Paul Moses. Oh, no need for this. No need at all. Absolutely no need for this sort of thing. Keighley need to hang tightly to the ball, not try the fancy stuff. They've got the score on the board. Substitution being made. Ian Gately coming back on. Joe Grimmer goes off.
certainly a good game, good solid game for Keith Lee, leading that pack. Back knock form properly, goes in, knows that ball, it's the circling. Differential penalty to Workington, handing out, says the referee, attempted handing out by Keith Lee. Epi gets the ball one-handed and he's tackled there. Mark Brooke-Cowden. That's the other centre, Neil Rooney. Not seen a great deal of him. 10 metres rather, inside the Keefe half of the field. Ball going across Kitchen. Ian Scott coming on the blind foil there. Ball went back, says the referee. Armstrong getting the ball out over there to Heppy. Heppy's all over the field at the moment. That's a knock-on. Paul Byrne, perhaps the first mistake Paul Burns has made all day. And he knocks on there. And it's a grateful Keefe that says thank you very much. All they've got now is get the ball from this scrum and hold on for six. As we've said two or three times so far this last 10 minutes or so. Ball into the scrum, it's out. Andy Ayres looking for a hole through. Byrne there in the centre position almost. Dixon, Carlton Farrell. He won't make any mistakes, I doubt. He'll just hold tight to that ball. Nothing will panic that guy, I don't think. Into trying to do something unnecessary. Is that Gately or is it Kerr? Difficult to tell the pair apart when they're with the long black hair. Gately it is, though. Mark Brooke-Cowden. Being driven back fully 10 metres there as he tried to get further upfield and struggled. Play the ball to himself. Now then, the marker hadn't got there, I don't think. Is Mr. Crashley going to say he had? He says he had indeed. You can have a look at that again, but suspect he hadn't quite made it there. Mr. Crashley thinks differently. That ball then punted downfield into touch. 15 metres from the line as Armstrong looked to pass, then decided to go himself. Well, did he play that ball himself or what? In fact, he's penalised. Penalised by the referee, says the keeper player didn't allow him to get up and play the ball. I suspect perhaps Mr. Crashley bought a pint of milk there. Maguire plays the ball, Penman onto Marwood, Marwood to Kitchen, Kitchen to Ogilvie, and Keith Lee going to be penalised there for holding the man who was going to take the ball, holding him back. Kitchen takes the tap, Marwood short on numbers at the far side. Oh, well, 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 would you believe it? Would you believe it? John Beattie had the try area at his mercy, and in all honesty, that's three tries that Workington in this half have refused to accept. Three absolute sitters, really, and Keith Lee, I think, if they're honest, going to say that they've been quite fortunate not to have had 12 points scored against them, and what a difference that would have made to the scoreline. Time up on my watch there now. I reckon we're now into time added on for injuries and stoppages of one thing and another. And there's been one or two of those. Jason Ramshaw just having a little laugh at the opposition there. He knows what the score is. Dixon kicks through, semi-obstructed. Ken Kerr kicks on. Martin Wood chases. Kitchen's there. He misses it. And they all miss it, so it's a dropout under the post there. Kitchen, the last man to touch it. A very, very good kick and chase there, though. Kerr was certainly up there. Martin Woods was with him. And it was only the
the despairing hand there of Wayne Kitchen that presented that prevented another try for Keighley. Ball down there, not a very good dropout. Carlton Farrell drives in, met there by Scott and Armstrong, just inside the Workington half of the field. And if that's not allowing a man to get up, I don't know what is. And it's Carlton Farrell that gets penalised. Well, you're a joke, Mr. Crashley, aren't you, really, at times? You've made us laugh on occasions, but it's frustrations like that that cause players to get upset and lose their tempers. And quite frankly, Carlton Farrell was not being allowed to play the ball there by Armstrong. And yet he's penalised for not playing the ball. Time definitely up now, deep into stoppage time. 18 points to 2 the score. Keighley certainly got this game stitched up, but don't want to allow any score at all now. 18-2, 16 difference. That could make a lot of difference at the end of the day, at the end of the season. Oh, ball going to ground there, and again. And it's a knock-on. Could have been knocked out of his hands, but the referee was within a yard of the action, and we've got to assume that he did see what happened. Conditions as they are, ball like a lump of soap. Phil Paul, oh, he too loses the ball. Keith Dixon picks it up, though, and it'll be a scrum down 20 metres from the line in the Keighley half of the field. One assumes that the timekeeper's watches haven't stopped. But certainly we're extremely well into injury time now. That ball out to Workington, Marwood, and Kitchen has the last play. The timekeeper says that's it. The referee says that's it. And Keighley come out with an 18 points to 2 win. Thanks to 5 goals by John Basilou, an absolutely superb try from Andy Hinchliffe, where the ball was popped up again, we believe, by Keith Dixon, and this top left-hand corner of the field, and that final try by Andy Ayres. After the opening had been created, John Walker streaked up the wing, he went up the wing, Andy Ayres was inside him, and he streaked, as we said, like a rabbit to the line to finish it off. And there we go, that's a very good win for Keighley in this first match of the new season. Keighley 18, Workington 2. Thank you.